minute. If the demo bots don't want me to show this demo, it might break, but just hoping that it works. Okay, so, and most of these items that you're seeing today is all available in the market, so you can basically get them. Let's see if, okay. So this is basically the BMO Belkin's netcam. I've just kept it at the living room today just to show the demo. Now you can see there's a few things over here. Not sure. One thing is you notice that I don't have a TV at home. Okay. Wife says no TV. What do I do? Go and get a project. Okay. So I have a project actually placed here, which you can't see. It's very small. This is my home theater system. Okay. Then this is my Xbox. This I'm going to show you right now. Then you have something here. So let's see if this works. Okay. So this Google Home is connected to my account. So technically, if I say something over here, it should start triggering things over there. Okay. So say, let's hope it works. Hey Google, cleaning time.
Sure, let me transform myself into a vacuum robot and do my magic by cleaning home.
So you can see, this is LG vacuum robot. It doesn't have this functionality as such, but you can see that it will start going around, start cleaning the house and stuff. You can see that because the streaming is a bit bad, but you can see that screen. So at the same time, you can say, hey Google, stop cleaning. Hey Google, stop cleaning.
Sure, I am done cleaning and I am heading back to my station to re-energize.
Let me make a full screen. So, right now what's happening is it's going back. And whatever the commands that you just heard, it's all given by me. So that means you can add character into your commands, you know. So we just did partial clean of just one slide, but technically what happens is if I leave this entire, all my doors open, the cleaning bot actually goes, cleans up the entire house, except my studio rooms. I have to tell because I have these lights, studio lights with a tripod stand, which has a very thin width to it. So it's not able to recognize that. So except my studio room, which is closed, it cleans up everything else. So now that's done. Next is, let's see if we can. But here's a scenario. I go in the evening, after 6 o'clock, once I enter my house, the lights turn on automatically. I don't even say the Google command, okay? I have set certain triggers basically on my phone, so it knows that the moment I'm within the area of my house, which I define, I walk up to it. And it will automatically trigger an event, which would then turn on all the lights. So my lights are technically, the switch is always turned on. So when I want to turn off the lights, I can turn it off. So next scenario is where, first things when I did, I wanted to make sure my entertainment was really cool. So what I did was I kind of configured my home theater system. It is over here to the projector, and since it's a projector, you know how light interferes with the clarity, right? So I wanted to dim the lights, right? And I wanted to all of this happen at the same time. You can see my projector is turned off right now, my home theater is turned off, lights are turned on. Okay, I can either say the command or I can go and sit in the couch. So I have a motion sensor which I place facing the couch. So if I go and just sit, everything starts playing on its own. So let's see if this works. Hey Google, turn on TV.
Sure, working my magic. Sit back, relax, and have fun.
So let's see if this works. So you can see the lights went off. It's dimmed, yeah, just like now. You can see that the projector is booting up. You can also see that the home theater system has come on. And I've also kind of like linked multiple HDMIs together, like your Edo TV, then the Google Chromecast. I'm using a Google Chromecast over here to cast things directly onto the thing. So, okay, I'll give you a brief history. Google just started with few devices. You know, the Philips Hue lights that you see over there, okay? And you had LifeFX as one of the other devices. And they just started with very few. Now, if you go into the Google Home app under devices, you'll find a list of manufacturers that supports Google Home by default. But hey guys, you always have a product which is not over there, which you like to link. So all these stuff that I've done over here, it's not directly linked to Google Home. Some of them are, but what I've done is I've used IFTTT. Have you guys heard about IFTTT? So connected through that to the Google Assistant and then to the Google Home. Okay, so now you can see that the project is turned on and I can say, hey Google, play Stranger Things from Netflix on TV.
Okay, Stranger Things from Netflix, playing on Chromecast Ultra 9558.
So that's the Chromecast that I'm using. So you can see that the Netflix is turned on, okay, just with the voice command. And by the way guys, you see this table over here, all the remotes in the house is dumped inside. I no longer use remotes. It's just voice. So the movie started. And you can also say, hey Google, pause TV. It's paused. Hey Google, resume TV. That's working. Now, let's stop this. Hey Google, stop TV. So it'll come out. So it'll come out, go back into the screensaver mode. Then I can say, what happens now when I want to turn off the TV, right? I want to walk away. So either if I'm there, it will automatically detect I'm gone. After 1 minute, I've set the interval, it will all turn the lights back on. So I say, hey Google, turn off TV.
All right, switching off TV.
So you see slowly that the projector and, so you can see the projector is getting turned off. The home theater system should turn off automatically after some time. You can see that's going, you can see that the lights are back on. So this is like a classic example of how Internet of Things works, right? So